So the first one we need to talk about is PUMA, the brand itself. It's 75-year anniversary. You've been with the brand 20 years now.
That's what I'm saying. I felt like I've been here for half the, half that time.
It's crazy, 20 years. Let's go back to the very beginnings. What's so special about PUMA, the brand, and your association?
This is a brand that I've always wanted to stay with. And then over the years, you get to know almost everybody throughout the company. You've been in PUMA for a long time also. You know what I mean? So we just became a family. And throughout the years, we've done so many good work, so many good things. So for me, I just happy to be a part of the brand.
When you became a massive superstar, you must have had the opportunity to go to any brand. So why stick with PUMA?
You know what I mean? When I started out as a junior, I was pretty good. But when I started transitioning into a professional athlete, it was a bad transition. There was a lot of injuries, there was a lot of problems. For me, I wasn't as focused then, so it took me a while to get going. So surprisingly, my contract ran out just before I really started doing well, you know what I mean? And they kind of stood by me, because they could have cut my contract or said, you know what, we're not re-signing you. But they were like, you know what, we see the potential, we've been with you and we believe in you.
Do you remember your first boxer kit when it arrived? What it was like?
I was just coming out of high school. You had probably like 7 pair of shoes, you know what I mean? You had one spike that you had to wear constantly, you know what I mean? So the fact that when I got my kit, I had like 3 pair of spikes. That was a massive deal, you know what I mean, for me. So to get all these shoes and all these gears, it was exciting, man. I was like a kid in a candy store.
Did it change your perception of what your abilities are? You know, especially when you set that first, the 100 meter world record was your first of your world record. So did you think then, oh, actually, I am a really good sprinter? Or did you just go, oh, where did that come from?
My coach was not surprised.
Right.
But I was.
Right.
But I knew I was running quick times and doing well, but when I broke the world record, for me, it was never about the world record. The first 2 times I broke the world record, I was never thinking about it. The stadium was packed with Jamaicans. So I'm like, no, I need to win this, you know what I mean? So that was my main focus going into that track meet. And when I won, it was like, I didn't even look at the clock. Throughout my career, I never really focused so much on world records, but mostly medals.
Then when you're the world record holder, I mean, people's expectations of you then are insane, because every time you're on the track, they're expecting magic
exactly,
to happen,
yeah.
Right? So how would you balance that with your own personal well-being? How would you keep control of that in your mind?
I think people are more impressed with just my personality, I think. They want me to perform, to run fast, but they're looking for the performance, you know what I mean? What is he gonna do? When he wins, is he gonna dance? Is he gonna cheer? What? So I think people are so much focused on that. It was never a pressure, because I know as long as I'm in good shape, as long as I'm well trained, then I know that I have no worries.
What's the last 20 meters like of those races for you? When you're just charging the last 20, are you thinking, hell, I haven't caught them yet?
That's one thing you have to learn. Never panic. The moment you panic, you lost.
Right.
That's one thing I've learned through all the years. I remember before 08, I lost to Safa in the 100 meters in Stockholm. And I remember when you were going out there, my coach said to me, listen, the starter is very quick. He just goes set and go. And for some reason, I don't know where my mind was. I totally did not remember that he actually said that. So as soon as the guy went set, the gun went, you know what I mean? And I was left in the blocks. Safa was gone. And I panicked. I just got up and started running, you know what I mean? Because I didn't understand everything at the time, and I just got up and started running. I almost caught him on the line, but I didn't get there. So I learned that from that moment on. No matter if I get a bad start, let's go through your steps.
Budapest is round the corner, literally, in that sense. I mean, how excited are you as a retired athlete now, and I guess still a fan of athletics, to look at the World Championships and see what potential is out there?
Yeah, the season is almost in full swing now.
Mm.
So now you're gonna start seeing who is gonna step up, who is doing well, and you can say, all right, this guy's doing well. This is gonna be a great competition. So for me, I'm always excited to listen to the results, see races, and see what's going on. So I'm excited to see in which direction, who is gonna be the big competitors when the season really gets going.
Final question. What word of advice would you give to any young aspiring athlete in this day and age?
It's just to never give up, you know what I mean? Understand that the road is never easy. There will be challenges, there will be setbacks, but just believe in your dreams, because for me, I never thought in the longest dream or in my life I would be the fastest man in the world, you know what I mean? I wanted to be great, but I worked hard and I wanted to do great, so I just gave it my all, you know what I mean? So just work hard, sacrifice, believe in yourself, believe in your dream, and believe that you can do it and it will happen, you know what I mean?